So, hello guys. Since we got a new mainboard here, I noticed we have a free NVMe M2 slot free there. And yeah, I set the Samsung 970 Evo and Evo Plus on my watch list. And see there, Black Friday is up and yeah, 25% price decrease. And yeah, so we got them now below 100 euros for these ones. Actually, if you're looking into SSDs, if you go with the Crucial, you probably get it for about 80 at the moment. And they're usually around 100. But I think that the price we are now getting at the Black Friday and Cyber Monday and whatever week, these are probably the prices which we will have at some time in 2021. So if you don't have the money at the moment, just wait a little bit. It's always a good thing. What we don't want to do in this video is to move the installation. We just want to install the SSD here, format it, move a couple of Steam games over, test the speed. So that's the focus of the video. No, as I said, not moving the main installation because it's already on a Samsung SATA SSD. And if you're worried about the speeds of SSDs, there's a really nice video from Linus Tech Tips, for example, and others out there. For gaming, it really does not make that much of a difference in most scenarios. So there's a huge difference between having an HDD and an SSD, of course. For most games, I must say, some games it's not so much of a difference at all. So that's a big improvement there, especially if you have your operating system on the SSD. But in those cases where you are looking between different SSDs, the differences. They only show up if you have like a huge amount of file operations, moving files from A to B. Then it makes a bit of a difference, and maybe if you're using if this is your job or something, it's maybe worth about money. But usually, if you have no SSD to SSD, that helps a lot. And in this case, it's more like getting more SSD space because we have a small SSD, like most systems nowadays have. And now we're getting a 1 TB SSD for our games as second drive. A third drive in this case. So it's actually something you want to watch. If you are already owning a system, should check me because maybe you don't have an NVMe M2 slot free anywhere, and then that's not really, or it's more difficult of an option. And the SATA drives are much cheaper anyway, so that's maybe an option you could choose or take to save some money and some headache moving over installation and such. Yeah. Without further ado, let's go into the video and install the thing in it. Here in this computer, you need to remove the graphics card. It's probably not so good with the graphics cards, it's still directly beside the SSD because they're a little bit heat sensitive, but yeah, I hope it should work out here. So let's dive deeper into this installation. So here we got the SSD in all its tiny little glory. Actually, we had a big problem here because I was missing a fitting screw to mount the SSD. And yeah, it was with the mainboard. There was a little small bag with NVMe 2 SSD written on it, and I was sure it was in the mainboard box, but either the cat got it out of the box or I put it somewhere else to be absolutely certain I won't lose it. So that screw was gone, so this is something you may should check before ordering such a thing, because you can get sets for your mainboard. You need, like, for your mainboard manufacturer, a fitting set with either those adapters and screws, or just like a couple of notebook screws. It's not too expensive, but in my case, we have a little computer store in town, so they could give me a fitting screw, which was quite nice of them. But it's actually what you almost kind of expect. Also, we could set three lengths here if we would have a shorter SSD, and this is working like a little screw of itself, so you can get your screwdriver in it and then just screw it in. The longest setting was the fitting one. I just removed it so I could show it to the store and they could search a fitting screw for me. Without further ado, let's put this thing in the computer and see if it still works. So, yeah, now first we have to get in the holder for the screw, the right size, which is the biggest one here. Then the NVMe 2 SSD we have to put in, first in and then down. You can't actually do it a wrong way. There's a little pin here, little leftover space. When it's down, we have to get a screw to hold it in place. Thanks to the local PC store for providing that little screw. See, and after we get in, too much force is not recommended on either doors of those screwings. As always, let's go into the formatting. So only press Windows key, then type in format, enter, and the Windows formatting program is starting. Once you create a boot record, which we did, then we need to scroll down to our new drive and now create a new volume, and the formatting is directly in the dialog. So usually we don't need to change anything here from my point of view. We give it letter F in this case. You can select pre, but it's usually A, B, C, D, E, F. And yeah, I name it SSD2 here to make a little bit of a distinction, but yeah, it's not too important. And formatting on on a NVMe2 SSD does go really fast. So with the HD, this usually takes a couple of minutes, as far as I remember. I haven't done it in years. So now I show you how to change your folder in Steam. Your download folder, go to settings, downloads, and then add library folder. Actually, you can create folders in that dialog. Actually, I do screen capture here because the production value on my channel is immensely, extremely high. So new folder there, and I think this the default name is just enough. And selected. We can change the default one. I didn't do that right away. I'm doing that a little bit later because at first I had that idea that maybe I would install the games first on the HDD and then move them over if I recognize that the download speeds are too slow. But actually, with 1 TB, why even bother? I'd much rather will move games I do not play so much on the on my D drive here, which is the HDD. So now let's go into the benchmark here. This takes a couple of minutes, but due to the magic of editing and everything else, I can forward you a little bit here. So if you don't need to watch the whole 6 minutes. And actually my regular, this 840 Evo 256 GB drive where I have my operating system on, did perform much better than usual, but it's like still 7 times slower than, between 5 and 7 times slower than the new SSD. And yeah, the normal drive does not even show up. It's like even another 5 times slower. So it's really, in theory, a really big difference. Where it matters is mostly like stuff like file transfers and loading times in some games. But for example, Witcher 3, I had really excellent loading times with my HDD already. So I moved the game, but like Star Wars Squadrons had really bad loading times. So I hope that will improve a little bit with SSD. Like for The Witcher, I would usually say it's not really necessary to move it, but yeah. Since the prices have gone so much down, now I'm showing you like some games like War Thunder here, for example. You cannot move the folder directly from Steam, so we have to cut it on its original place and paste it here. And then we have to select uninstall in Steam and install it once more, but therefore we have to change the default drive. Just select right trick, click here, and then we will install it on the default drive. And then instead of downloading the whole game, checks, oh, there are a couple of files. Just use them once again and downloads a little few files there. But yeah, it's done in a couple of seconds instead of it was pronouncing like 1.5 days for downloading. Actually, my internet connection is much faster, but I think they show for a very, very slow DSL connection how long it would take. But yeah, change the language actually, but that's easily changed again. So yeah, overall SSD, I think it's definitely worth the money to have one, but I wouldn't necessarily go for NVMe2 if you don't have the slot, or if you already have one. A SATA is quite good as well. I'll put the video to Linus Tech Tips where they compared SSD speeds below, because this was really eye-opening for me. But there are other videos out there which compare loading speeds in games, and they have a very similar, they make a very similar experience. So I think, of course, it's mostly centered on gaming here. If you are doing something else, like moving huge files around a lot, or maybe you're on the clock at work and have to wait for file transfers, it's maybe more interesting to have a faster SSD. Yeah, I'll put a couple of affiliate links in the description. Yeah, if you use them and buy something, I'll get a little bit of a provision from Amazon. But yeah, I think you know that game. I hope it was somewhat informative for you guys. Yeah, as I said, fast SSD is, in my eyes, for very few people, you really have a huge benefit. But having an SSD against having an HDD, certainly a good thing and not so expensive anymore. But yeah, like, use a price searching machine and set your alarm when it gets to the price where you are comfortable with buying it. It's my biggest.